God, you alone can bring into order the unruly wills and affections of sinners. Grant your people grace to love what you command and desire what you promise, that among the swift and varied changes of the world, our hearts may surely there be fixed where true joys are to be found. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, who makes a way in the sea, a path in the mighty waters, who brings out chariot, horse, army, and warrior. They lie down, they cannot rise. They are extinguished, quenched like a wick. Do not remember the former things, or consider the things of old. I am about to do a new thing. Now it springs forth. Do you not perceive it? I will make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. The wild animals will honor me, the jackals and the ostriches. For I give water in the wilderness, rivers in the desert, to give drink to my chosen people, the people whom I formed for myself, so that they might declare my praise. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. If anyone else has reason to be confident in the flesh, I have more. Circumcised on the eighth day, a member of the people of Israel, the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew born of Hebrews. As to the law, a Pharisee. As to zeal, a persecutor of the church. As to righteousness under the law, blameless. Yet, whatever gains I had, these I have come to regard as loss because of Christ. More than that, I regard everything as loss because of the surpassing value of knowing Christ Jesus my Lord. For his sake, I have suffered the loss of all things, and I regard them as rubbish, in order that I may gain Christ and be found in him, not having a righteousness of my own that comes from the law, but one that comes through faith in Christ. The righteousness from God based on faith. I want to know Christ and the power of his resurrection and the sharing of his sufferings by becoming like him in his death, if somehow I may attain the resurrection from the dead. Not that I have already attained this or have already reached the goal, but I press on to make it my own because Christ Jesus has made me his own. Beloved, I do not consider that I have made it my own, but this one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and straining forward to what lies ahead, I press on towards the goal for the prize of the heavenly call of God in Christ Jesus. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
6 days before the Passover, Jesus came to Bethany, the home of Lazarus, whom he had raised from the dead. There they gave a dinner for him. Martha served, and Lazarus was one of those at the table with him. Mary took a pound of costly perfume made of pure nard, anointed Jesus' feet, and wiped them with her hair. The house was filled with the fragrance of the perfume. But Judas Iscariot, one of his disciples, the one who was about to betray him, said, "Why has this perfume not sold for 300 denarii and the money given to the poor?" He said this not because he cared about the poor, but because he was a thief. He kept the common purse and used to steal what was put into it. Jesus said, "Leave her alone. She bought it so that she might keep it for the day of my burial. You always have the poor with you, but you do not always have me." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. In the name of God, Creator, Redeemer, and Sanctifier. Amen. What wonderful, rich lessons today on this fifth Sunday in Lent. We are still in Lent of the fifth Sunday. We're sort of beyond the apex. And we have this story of Jesus coming to his friend's home, coming for a meal, a man who has no place to lay his head, no room for his family at the inn. And he has resuscitated Lazarus, which likely was the final straw for him to be crucified. And dinner's being served, and Mary brings out this perfume that she's been holding on to. Not perfume, but anointing oil. You have in your, if you just open your bulletin where it is to the gospel, just bring it really close to your nose. I know it's hard when you've got a mask on, but breathe it in. It's faint, but it is our healing oil that is blessed by our bishop. And just that little bit of fragrance. So we haven't been able to restore our oils for the last couple of years, so the fragrance has lessened. But if you imagine that filling the room, this fragrant oil, and to breathe it in this moment, we are invited into the truth of what it means to have an incarnate God. So think about being embodied, and I know it's not always a blessing, but mostly it is, because what's the alternative, right? That's the joke. But think about just moving your toes in your shoes, or your fingers around, or lifting your shoulders. This embodiment. Like I said, it doesn't always feel like a blessing, and yet our God chose to take on a human form in all of its imperfections, to love and live with us, to celebrate to teach and heal and reach out to those on the outskirts. And so Mary knows what many of us know, that moment you want to hang on forever. Can I hug you once more? Can I hold your hand a little while longer? And so she anoints Jesus. I heard a term this week called sideways grief, where you're upset about this thing, but you go over here to this person. This way in which we may lash out, not fully express ourselves well. And we have Judas. And the reference that Jesus makes to the poor, we know that Jesus loved the poor, right? The reference is from Deuteronomy. But Jesus is also talking about discernment. That in the midst of grief, that grief that comes before the grief, Jesus says, focus on what's most important right now. You will always have life and all the things that go with it. You won't always have me. Lent is our season of discernment, our season of discerning what our song says about bringing forth joy. What will be the joy? I saw a video of a little boy about Winslow's age, and they were on stage for some acknowledgement at school, and the video is from the parents' perspective, and the boy's like walking along, looking concerned, and then he sees his parents, and he goes, yes! Isn't that the discernment of what's most important? And we hear in Isaiah, could not be more timely, army and warrior lie down, they cannot rise, they are extinguished, quenched like a wick. And God says this to the time of Isaiah, but God says this to us now. I'm about to do a new thing. Now it springs forth. Do you not perceive it? God speaks this not only to the Israelites, to us. I am doing new things again and again. It doesn't mean letting go of the old things. Is it challenging? Is it painful? You all might remember back last summer when we talked about regathering. And I was pretty emphatic about we're not going back. Because there are things in the last few years that have fallen away. And that's okay, because God is doing a new thing. And it's our challenge to be like Mary, to discern what is most of need. Where is God in the midst of us? So as we enter into these next few weeks, there's spoilers, you all know what's coming. But let us be present here now. Let us be in a place of discernment. Where is the joy? What is God doing anew in our hearts, in our minds, in this community, and in the world? Amen. Let us say together, we believe.
nation, and the world.
For all who work for justice, freedom, and peace.
For the just and proper use of your creation.
For the victims of hunger, fear, justice, and oppression.
For all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble.
For those who minister to the sick, the friendless, and the needy.
For the peace and unity of the Church of God.
For all who proclaim the gospel and all who seek the truth.
For all bishops, priests, and other ministers.
For all who serve God and the Church.
For the special needs and concerns of this congregation.
Margaret Aubrey, Karen Jo Boland, Leslie Bonino, Ann George, Cindy Bodenlos, Frederick C. Hawk Jr., the Hinkson family, Dylan Gura, Gail Miller Janton, Alan Goldberg and David Kosnick, Jay Janton, Pam Maxwell, Larry Margolis, the Plattering family, the Muffet Pauly, the Roche family, Yolanda Campolina, Mary Jo Schwan, Lisa Streving, the people of Ukraine, Russia, Afghanistan,
hear us, Lord.
We
thank you, God, for all the blessings of this life. We will exalt you, O God, our King.
And praise your name forever and ever.
We pray for all who have died, that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom.
For Mary Page Plattering.
God, let your loving kindness be upon them.
Put their trust in you.
O God, accept the fervent prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God,
we confess our sins against you, our thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, and by what we have left undone. We acknowledge you with our whole heart. We acknowledge our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, and have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and in all your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
do join us for them at 5.
Thank you. I have just 2 quick announcements. One is just to let you know where we stand on the search for a new rector. I'm 1 of 10 people on the search committee. Feel free to ask me. I see Charles Gordon is here. I saw someone else from our committee. I can't remember who. Feel free to ask us any questions. We had training this week with a woman from the diocese to help us with our interviewing skills. So I ask that you just pray that we get a lot of good candidates, that the search committee is talented enough to find the right candidates to commit to the vestry, and the vestry chooses the person that will be best for St. Paul's going forward. And the other announcement is some of us are getting ready to go to Mexico to build a house with Carzon, and we'd like you to join us. It's still not too late to sign up. My husband and I are going. David Long and his daughter are going. The Vandalak family are going. We certainly have room for others. So if you'd like to go to Mexico, contact us, or even Jocelyn. I'm not quite sure what Jocelyn's status is this week. Thank you.
We're not sure either. I do want to say about Corazon, I actually went as a teenager for the first time, and it's the community around that family actually says this is the family most in need. And then you go and you build a house, an entire house in a day, and they have a home. Jocelyn is out, she's actually in New Orleans for a family event, but she and Jessica welcomed baby Magdalena this week, so baby number 3. So congratulations and blessings to them. Also want to just highlight again the invitation to contribute to Easter flowers and music. And if you don't have the envelope, they are out here, but please do honor anybody or remember anybody with that. Let us with gladness present the offerings and oblations of our life and labor to God.
Thank you.
heaven and earth. You bid your faithful people cleanse their hearts and prepare with joy for the Paschal feast, that fervent in prayer and in works of mercy, and renewed by your word and sacraments, they may come to the fullness of grace, which you have prepared for those who love you. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. He took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ has risen. Christ will come. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O God, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace, and at the last day bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Creator, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. turning to page